Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for tuning in. Thank you so much for subscribing to my channel. Thank you so much for always supporting. I really really appreciate it. If you haven't subscribed to this channel, do the right thing and subscribe. And let's get right into the video. Okay guys, so the reason why you see me laughing, it's actually laughing out of disbelief, okay? So I actually just found out today that my company is going to lay me off, guys. Wow. Okay, let's start going back, okay? So I worked, obviously you know that in China there's this coronavirus, everything happening, right? Everybody worked in my company, worked for the month of February, and then we got a message, I think it was about the 20 something of February, and we usually get paid on the 3rd of the following month. Then they send us a message from the CEO of the company. They tell us that, no, you guys are going to get 50% of your salary. Imagine the audacity, okay? First of all, they're telling us last minute, okay? They're telling us literally a couple of days before we're supposed to get paid. They're telling us that, no, you're going to get 50% of your salary, and the senior managements, they're going to be getting 60%. Which was really, really stressful for a lot of people, because in China, we have to pay rent, you know, especially in the company that I worked at, you're supposed to pay for your own rent. It's not like the school pays for your rent. That is another disadvantage, guys. So if you're looking for a school in China, make sure that you have free accommodation, that you don't have to pay for your accommodation in case of such things happen. Now, we are getting half of our salary when we worked full time. And we have to be paying rent where we stay. And on top of that, you know, you have your normal, usual expenses that you have to take care of. And you have to be saving. That is the main point why you would be going to China in the first place, because you want to make money. And it was really, really annoying to find out really last minute. Okay, a lot of the employees, they try to fight it and things like that. But that didn't really work. Whether you were gonna, you know, agree to this or not agree to this, you still get the 50%, which was really stressful for a lot of people. And luckily, guys, for me, I had came home like literally before that announcement, which was so good. Like, I felt like it was so inspired by God, because I came home with my last money that I had in my account. I paid my rent for the next month, and I also paid for my ticket to come here. So literally in my bank account, I had left nothing. So to find out this news was really stressful, but I was so happy that at least I was able to be home, you know, with my husband, and I didn't have to stress like, oh my gosh, I'm in China in the middle of nowhere, I'm not with my family, I don't have money and things like that. A lot of people were really, really stressed, because now the landlord wants his money. You know, it doesn't care whether you didn't get paid or what, you know what I mean? And you still have to survive after that. So that was really, really stressful for a lot of people, a lot of my colleagues, a lot of, you know, employees of this company. Obviously, I'm not going to mention the company and things like that just to protect myself. But yeah, guys, this is my story. It's very, very, like, it's funny because, you know, you give your all to such things, you sacrifice a lot of things, and then this is kind of like the treatment you get after that, which is quite sad. But yeah, so today I got a call and I was told that, oh, we're laying you off. And it's not just me, a lot of the employees who arrived literally like 6 months back in the company, who joined the company 6 months back, are literally just being laid off. So literally a lot of people are in shock, a lot of people are surprised, a lot of people are not so surprised, because if the company is going to say they're going to give you 50% of your salary, you must definitely expect that that company is going to drown. And this was the case. So today I just found out that I will be staying permanently in South Africa, at least until I have all my documents back. and then maybe I'll think about what I'm gonna do after that. But as of right now, I don't have a job, guys. Imagine, guys. Like, imagine. It's weird. But you know what? It's life. It's my first time being laid off, guys. Like, this is my first experience in my entire life. You know, this is another thing about growing up. When you grow up, you just experience grown-up stuff. Like, the life gets real, you know? So, but anyway, you know, you just gotta take it as it is. Do what you gotta do. And, but guys, like, from me personally, I would advise you guys, if you are planning on going to China and you want your things to be like, guys, you need to like go on Instagram, search me Lesedi Konyana, Facebook Lesedi Konyana, inbox me and ask me questions to help you, or join groups that are, you know, like about people who are going to China and things like that. Ask questions, guys, because you don't want to find yourself in a situation where, you know, you are with a school, you know, a school that is, you know, just shady. I mean, I get right now also, you know, the situation is very tight because this coronavirus, you know, businesses and schools, they're not making money and things like that. Their businesses are going down and things like that. But at the end of the day, you have to make the right choice, because I do know other people who are still working in China and who are still getting their full salary and they're teaching online. And I was also teaching online, but still I was offered 50% of my salary, even though I was working still. So yeah, it is what it is. That is life. But yeah, guys, anyway, that is it for today. I just wanted to give you that little update of what's happening in my life. But yeah, see you soon with the next plan that I have for the future. Wow, guys, it is crazy, like ridiculously crazy. But anyway, see you soon. Bye.